This is the aftermath of an alleged attempted robbery on yours truly. I was walking through a parking lot, and I got jumped by two individuals who shall remain nameless, but one of them is allegedly a person in a video that we'll be having a look at momentarily. So as you can tell, my face is slowly morphing into the Giga Chad meme. So that's wonderful. Basically, what happened was, like, I was just walking through a parking lot, two people approached me, one of them just punches me straight in the fucking face, clocks me square in the face, or on the side, I forget which. I think on the side, because it's swollen there, not in the middle. Although I do have a slight bruising on my nose. I fall on my back, and they pummel me, both of them, just keep hitting me over and over again, and, you know, after the first punch, it actually stopped hurting, because immediately adrenaline kicked in, and I was like, oh my god, I have to get out of this situation that I'm in. So, first punch, hurts like a motherfucker. Second punch, doesn't really hurt, stopped feeling it, I fell to the impact, but not the sting of, you know, getting punched in the fucking face. So, repeatedly, I get hit, and my face swells up, my eye is a bit red. I had a black eye for, like, I don't know, a couple of weeks or so. They broke one of my f***ing ribs. I found out about that, like, days later, because I had a doctor's appointment, coincidentally, that I went to afterwards. And I went there, and I'm like, hey, doc, while I'm here, you know, my rib cage kind of hurts. And they checked it out. They're like, yeah, this is broken. I'm like, what? They're like, yeah. So I got some morphine to deal with that. It still hurts, but I stopped taking the morphine because I don't want to develop an addiction to it. My family, like the bloodline that I come from, we're like super prone to developing addictions, especially to painkillers. So I was just kind of like, okay, I can sleep now without medication. It still hurts, but I'll deal with it. So I'm good on that. So this is my face post-attack. And this, right here, is a video of one of the individuals who allegedly attacked me. So we're gonna be having a look at this. I get attacked. Some people intervene because they notice that I'm getting attacked in a parking lot. The two attackers, they run off. They run away. One of them gets caught. I hear from somebody who's, like, passed by. They're like, hey, they caught somebody doing something. And, you know, the people who helped me were like, oh, let's check it out. So we go there. This is what I see. And as soon as I see this, I start recording. Maybe I'm wrong about this, but I would reckon that it's paramount to record what happens immediately afterwards, and after you've been attacked, you know, because it's like, well, some other thing could transpire, something else could happen. You know, for your safety, you should record. If anything, you can maybe get some evidence. So I was just kind of like, I'm going to record. And I did. And this is the video. So we're going to be having a look at this right now. I love that. That's the beginning of the video. You know, I had a bit of, like, psychological trauma from this afterwards. I kept, like, experiencing the event in my mind over and over again, and I kept thinking, like, did I do anything wrong? Should I have acted differently? What if I had been more prepared? You know, and I started, like, blaming myself. And then I watched this video on my phone, and I'm like, no, I did nothing wrong. This person is pathetic. Immediately in the video, you'll hear this. Like, you're all f***ing Billy Badass, and you're like a street thug who f***ing like beats up people and takes their f***ing cash up until you get caught. Then, all of a sudden, it's like, you remind me of, like, there's like a character in Blair Witch 2 who gets caught, like, doing some sh*t. Like, the cops, they show him, like, you know, evidence of him doing this sh*t, and they're like, we got you now, you son of a bitch. And he's like, I swear to Christ! No, you don't get to be, like, a badass fucking thug, and then at the same time, blubber like a baby. So, here I am identifying the perp. I was just kinda like, he did it. He did it. Apparently, the dude holding him, I've watched this video over and over again, and I've noticed that, like, he is unaware of the fact that I got attacked. He's totally oblivious to that, up until, like, the witnesses that went there with me told him, like, no, this guy got assaulted. I don't know definitively, but I would imagine that he did something else right after attacking me and running off, which led to him being apprehended by this, individual. So right there, he said, I received a threat, or threats, I don't know which, it's not defined, this plural or single, but he's like, I got a threat, like, 3 weeks ago, which has nothing to do with this happening. So, to me, that just seems like he's playing victim. He's like, oh, you know, something horrible happened to me, and I'm upset about that. It's like, no, you're f***ing upset that you got caught. You got caught attacking somebody for no discernible good f***ing reason.
Det var han som lurer meg.
I didn't do anything. Wait, hold on, let me hear that again. I didn't do anything 3 weeks ago. What? That's actually what he said, verbatim. I didn't do anything 3 weeks ago. Is that like a Freudian slip? Like, you did do something just now? Or what? What is that? He corrected himself. He's just like, right now! Just now! So he points at me and he says, he jumped me. First off, he's like a head taller than me, so how would I possibly do that? Second of all, he's a head taller than me, so why would I do that? And third of all the witnesses are saying that you attacked me, so... the fuck? It gets even more absurd as it goes on. Hold on, listen to this. I mean, like, I know most of you don't speak Swedish, but just, I'll translate. So I'm indignant at this point. I'm like, what the fuck? Not only did I get attacked, I'm being falsely accused of attacking the attacker. So I basically just said, like, what the hell? What are you saying? You guys saw that he attacked me. Look at my hand. That's what he says. So it's like, okay, let's go back to the picture that I showed you. So let's speculate. Let's just like imagine how I attacked him, because like his evidence for me attacking him is that his hand hurts. He got like a boo-boo on his hand. And this is my face at that moment. So broken rib, swollen face, red eye, and then like a black eye developed as time went on. Bruise on my nose, bruises on like my f***ing arm. All of this, and he's got like his hand hurts a bit. Does that make any f***ing sense? Does that make a lick of sense to anybody in the chat or like anyone on the internet? Does this make any f***ing sense? No, it's absurd. Like. What is being alleged? That, like, I attacked him with my face? Oh, let me just hit your hand with my face. Or what? Like, let me jump into you with my rib. Like, it doesn't make any f***ing sense, dude. So there, one of the witnesses is like, no. He attacked him. Yeah, and the dude apprehending him is like, did he attack him? Okay, so there's a saying in Swedish. It's like slog sönder, which is like beat to broken, or like, you know, you've been beaten to a point where you're broken. Like verbatim, that's what it would be if I translated it. So he's saying that I beat the fuck out of him. That's basically what he's saying. And he's like, look at my hand. Like your hand, what? There's not even any blood on it. There's nothing there. Even like, what even fucking happened? Like, again, this is me behind the fucking phone, like, with my phone out, recording him, saying that, like, I got attacked by him. Witnesses are saying he attacked me. This is what I look like in that moment. And he's like, look at my hand! So he's like, you know, should we get out of here? So he's like, stop recording! He's asking them to ask me to stop recording, which, I did not. I kept recording because this is evidence, and I've just been f***ing assaulted. So, no, I'm not gonna stop recording, dude. It's a public setting, I have the right to f***ing record, especially if some illegal, harmful shit has just transpired, and I've been the victim of it, and I've sustained injuries to the extent that one of my ribs is broken, which, you know, to this guy's defense, he doesn't know exactly what happened, but I'm just saying that, like, I think that I'm well justified in recording this catastrophe, this meltdown happening that we're looking at. Oh, by the way, that's as far as I know, which is I reckon that the woman right next to this guy, that's his significant other, and she's attempting to calm him down because he's having a public freakout. He's having a fucking meltdown. People are gathering, people are calling the cops, security guards are definitely on the way, and she realizes, like, hey, my boyfriend is having a fucking meltdown, and he's sobbing uncontrollably and making a fucking ass of himself. So, you know, hey, you know, come on, let's just get out of here. She keeps, like, attempting to, like, pull him aside, and he just ignores her. She's not even there as far as, like, his fucking actions go. She's, like, totally neglected, which I find kind of amusing. So he said, ask him to stop recording and I'll talk calmly. He did not. Even when I stopped recording, he kept, like, making a fucking scene. I have, for the most part, recovered from all my injuries. I'm pursuing legal action against this individual. I don't know about the other one who attacked me because, you know, he got away, I think. I don't know, maybe there's, like, CCTV or some shit. I don't know. But yeah, I am pursuing legal action. I will be seeking compensation for my injuries and for the trauma and just because f*** him. That's it. That's what happened to me. So if you're wondering, you know, what's up with this picture? Yeah, if you're wondering what's up with this, there you go. I feel like this is meme material. Like, I thought about posting this picture and just, like, you know, tweeting, like, you know, Strauss Zelnick came to my home or some shit. But I was like, okay, maybe I shouldn't do that. But I feel like this is, like, meme-worthy. Maybe that's just me, but if you guys want to make some memes out of this, I'm cool with it. I encourage you to do that. I think comedy is a good way of coping with these kind of events. And of course, like, people are different. Like, somebody who might be in this position might not feel the same. But this is how I feel. So if you want to have fun with this image, go ahead. I don't mind. I look forward to it. You can submit your memes at r/swegta. Or just tweet them to me, whichever you prefer.